Hello everyone, it's Double A here. Today I'm going to be showing you how to tune an FM audio subcarrier with a fairly simple and easy to use plugin that was created by a viewer of mine, Viso266, from an IQ file I sent him of this station. So this replaces the previous method I've made in a previous video of installing a virtual audio cable and then feeding the audio output from one instance of SDR Sharp to another.
In the first part of this video, I will demonstrate how to get your RTL SDR set up with the correct driver. If you've already done this, you can skip to the next chapter in this video. So first you want to click the link in the description to the RTLSDR.com quick start guide. And scroll down to the SDR Sharp setup guide header. Under here, click the link to download the Microsoft .NET 5.0 32-bit redistributable. And you might have to click to download manually. And save that installer to your downloads folder. Once it's finished downloading, you're going to want to run that installer. And click install. You might have to click yes to a confirmation prompt. And once it's done, you can close out. Next, you're going to want to install the AirSpy software-defined radio package. So click the link to go to airspy.com, click download. And you're going to want to download the software-defined radio package. And go ahead and just save that to your downloads folder. Next, you're going to want to right click and extract all. And you're going to want to double click install-rtlsdr.bat. Once that's finished, you can just push any key and that will exit the command prompt window. And next, within that same SDR Sharp folder, you're going to want to right-click zadig.exe and run as administrator. You might have to click yes to a confirmation prompt. Now, in here, you're going to want to click on options, check list all devices, and then uncheck ignore hubs or composite parents. And then click the drop down and select bulk in interface, interface 0. Be very careful to ensure that you're selecting this option. And then you'll want to confirm that USB ID is what is displayed here. And next, you're going to want to click install driver. It might also say replace driver instead of install driver in case Windows automatically installed a different driver previously.
After you have SDR Sharp installed, you want to go to this website, and there are some directions on how to install it here. If you already have an older version 1785 and below, you might need to follow slightly different directions than what I'm going to show in this video. But go to the releases tab, and then what you need to download, the only thing you really need for this plugin to work is this DLL, sdrsharp.scatuner.dll. So let's go ahead and download that. And I'm going to save it as, and I'm going to find my directory that the SDR Sharp folder is in, and then go to the plugins subdirectory there, and save this DLL to plugins. Now you're gonna get some warnings that this, you know, a DLL can contain a virus. This software is safe. I've tested it. So you can go ahead and click keep, and it might really warn you depending on what web browser you're using. But we want to keep that DLL and again place it in the SDR Sharp 86 folder in the plugin subfolder. Now, when we go to run sdrsharp.exe, I'll go ahead and click play a while, and I am tuned to 89.5 WITF in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, which is the station I used previously to demonstrate an FM audio subcarrier. And once the DLL is in that plugins folder, you should be able to just click the hamburger menu and go to SCA Tuner. And by default, it appears it's set to 67 kilohertz, which is the frequency this station happens to use for its FM subcarrier. And if I just click enable, I will hear the subcarrier audio.
So it's a good option for people on a gluten-free diet. Important.
Now, if you have the Zoom FFT menu enabled here, and you click the enable MPX checkmark, you can see the FM multiplex down here, which will indicate where the SCA frequency is at, if there even is one, and this can be helpful in finding it. So, here I have the baseband audio here below, 15 kHz, the stereo pilot in 19 kHz, the stereo left minus right difference, double sideband suppressed carrier, subcarrier, centered at 38 kilohertz. And then at 57 kilohertz, we have the radio data system subcarrier, again, centered at 57. So any additional subcarriers are going to be above 57. And we can see this peak here at about 67, which is for this radio station broadcasting a radio reading service for the blind, where, from what I understand here, they read mainly news stories, there's even recipes sometimes, and books, all kinds of different things, just, you know, content that someone who's blind wouldn't be able to have access to. And from what I understand, they make a special radios for blind people that can tune these subcarriers in easily. And of course, a specific unit would only work in a certain area. And nowadays, a lot of these subcarriers are going away in favor of an online format. So these are rare, getting rarer. Sometimes they're on 92 kilohertz, but I think 67 is the most common.
Keep the fish chilled to less than 40 degrees Fahrenheit.
So right now we're hearing the subcarrier audio. By go ahead and uncheck enable, we're hearing the main NPR radio station that you would hear, which is just a regular radio that you tuned in to 89.5.
Try to find super frozen or blast frozen fish instead of fish that was conveniently frozen at negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit.
And if you have some sound quality issues, this plugin does not allow you to select the bandwidth of the SCA subcarrier, which in my first video about this, you can adjust the bandwidth. It is a bit more complicated than the setup. I'll post a link down in the description below. But if you are experiencing some audio issues, what you can do is ensure that the entire bandwidth of the FM radio station is set correctly. So a bandwidth too high, like what I have now, will sound kind of bad. And a bandwidth too low will sound kind of bad, so you kind of want to make sure all these, like, lumpy parts are contained within this bandwidth you have set. Additionally, if you're having sound quality issues, you can try going to the settings gear icon and adjusting the RF gain.
And more plant-based protein. Studies usually use
For most radio stations, there is a sweet spot of the lowest static. Generally, if you're closer to the tower, you need less RF gain than if you're further away from the tower. There is an auto gain control option here, which might work in some areas, but I found that just setting the gain manually allows you to get the cleanest signal. Also, if the SCA subcarrier doesn't happen to fall on exactly 67 or 92 kHz, there is this fine-tune option.
Also experience improved insulin sensitivity.
but this one seems to be at pretty much about 67 kilohertz. Maybe 67500 sounds a little better, but it's a nice little plugin, and I give all credit to the creator, Viso266. Appreciate his work on this. He actually used an IQ file of this station I sent to him because he did not have a station with SCA in his area. So I appreciate that he made this, and I'm glad that I was able to help.
Try to prevent COVID coming into the country.
So I hope you found this helpful and interesting, and maybe you can try to find an FM radio station using a subcarrier in your area. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video and are interested in more RTL SDR content, please consider subscribing.